Hello, on this video I'm gonna show you how to create a database on Azure using a DreamSpark account, the free student account, and also how to create a login and a user. So let's go to portal.azure.com. So once I log into the portal, I'm going to click on New, Data in Storage, SQL Database. I'm going to give it a name and the server configuration. Since I do not have a server, I'm going to create a new server. And click OK. Everything else I'm going to leave as default and click on Create. And this takes a long time. Here we are. I'm now interested on show database connection strings. And I'm going to copy the ado.net and I'm going to paste it on a notepad. And my server is this. So I'm interested on the server. I'm interested on the DB. And also on the ID. Everything else is not relevant for now. I'm going to now open the SQL Server Management Studio and click on Connect. And the server name is what we copy. The authentication is SQL Server. The login is the login I created. And the password is whatever you type when you're creating the database. I'm going to click on Connect. And now I have a problem. And the problem is that the SQL Server that I created does not trust my machine. So I'm going to fix this. Back to the portal. Click on the server name. And then show firewall settings and add client IP address. Click on save. Now back to my SQL Server Management Studio. Click on connect. And that works now. Expand database, and here is my database. Now, whenever you're using a SQL Server on a local machine, you have the GUI to create your database, your users, and whatnot. But whenever you're working with Azure, you don't. All you have is your SQL. So let's use the SQL to create some tables. So I have nothing here. I'm going to right click and new table. And gives me the SQL to create the table. So, I'm honestly not the best person to write the queries to create a table. And the reason is because I just don't do it often. So, what I do is very simple. I go to a local machine, a local SQL server that I have, and then I build my table the way I want to build. And then once I do that, I script table create to clipboard, or if you want to, create a new query editor and just copy this whole thing here. And then I just paste right here on the query that's going to create the table on Azure. Now, this is from my database, local database, so I'm just going to delete this. And then I also want to change the database name to just person. After that, I run it. And I have a newly created table. So refresh. And here's my table in Azure. The next step is to create a login. So on security, notice that it's the security from the database server, not from the database. So on the security, I'm going to right-click new, login. And here's the query. So login, the name is going to be web user. And the password is going to be something easy for now. So ABC 123. And the login is created. Now inside the DB, on security, on user, I'm gonna right click new user. So create the user, the same name at web user for login web user with default schema equals prog117db. And then I wanna add, I do not want to add DB owner. I want to add DB data reader. And the user is web user. And I also want to add another role, data writer, also for the web user. Basically, I'm creating a user and a login that I'm going to use on my website to log in and basically read and write data to that table. Execute. And this is good. And now, I'm going to open Visual Studio and I'm going to create a new project.